like all of his.
Oh, they're taking the time.
Northeast Kansas Hydraulics, that's for a thumb cylinder on the excavator.
$700 and $47.
There's a stop sign, warning sign, 218 Road.
218?
When it comes up to the highway.
Yeah, that'd be a state.
It's just a warning sign.
It says top ahead, or?
Yeah.
Yes, that'd be the state sign. It's on 218, it's like?
Yeah.
218, is it on the east or west side of the highway?
Yeah, on the west side.
I really regret it.
It's,
We have more roll-offs from the lake than Effingham transfer station?
Sometimes, yeah. That's why I think we ought to.
I think we ought to nix it.
Yeah.
You see that, Tom? They dumped out 8 roll-offs from the lake, more than the Effingham transfer station.
Yeah, how long?
In a month, less than a month.
Yeah, was there 7 from Effingham and 8?
8 from the lake.
Lake?
It's 2 weeks. Actually, it's less than a month, because it's from July 23rd to the 16th.
Tell me we should make a check.
Tells me that people are dumping probably illegally, you might get us from that county.
Yes, I mean. How are you gonna stop it?
Put in a small dumpster and.
And trash over in, they come in.
Can put up cameras, we can.
People dumping it.
Well, the only other alternative that I can see is, like Mike talked about, would be building a fence around and only have it open certain hours where the lake people can watch it by, but they have things to do also.
Yeah.
And we don't have a manpower sense of matter just to watch it. So I'm not sure what the.
I think we should have dumpsters or receptacles for people that are really using the lake, but outside of that, I mean, Effingham's not that far, Ashton's not that far, you can haul your trash somewhere else, that's not a lot of money, that's over $1,000. We gotta look into seeing what we can do for smaller receptacle out there, see what that'll cost to change that.
Well, I told you I had some good news. The last 2 years I've turned in for a grant from Wildlife and Parks for a bridge out the county lake. And we actually got accepted on that. And, submitted for this grant, with all of the county labor was included in that. The total amount for the project was $57,222. And the Wildlife and Parks will pay $22,889 of that. Which, that labor, actually it'll, I don't really include the labor, so, actual material cost after we get our $22,889 from the state, it's gonna cost us $15,440 to build a bridge. So that's like a pretty good deal.
So, what do you have to do to get it?
We've gotta, buy the bridge, build the bridge, and then we'll get reimbursed as soon as we get done with it.
You don't have to sign it?
And yeah, that's, I've got a PO here for the, steel from Husker Steel. And, all of the permits, we've already got all the permits for it. We had turned in for those when we turned in for the grant. And, the funds will be available in about 2 weeks. It'll take about a month to get this bridge in. So, take it out of our special bridge fund, and as soon as we get reimbursed, I'll put it back in there. Should have it by the, we've got the cash in there to do that. I need to sign a PO to get the steel on the way.
Looks like they're reimbursing 40%. Is it pretty bad shape?
Yeah, it's been, I know when Russ Eckert was on the commission, he was always trying to get that bridge redone.
Bridges in the state.
You know, I don't know. I'm not sure. I had a little issue. Southern Star contacted me about a week or so ago. Right across from Walmart out there, they have a pumping station out there, and they were having a water issue. It was running off, I believe it's Logan Road out there, and was wanting me to look into that, and I actually had Pat go out there with me and look. I believe the city had annexed Southern Star's property there.
They did. This would be the road adjacent to that. There's a statute that provides that the county can notify the city of areas where they've annexed a parcel of property but not the road adjacent to it. I think you have some discretion on whether, in looking at a map and whatnot, you think that that ought to be part of the city. Essentially, you can force the city to take the road. That would give us an odd situation because you have the count. The township would have the northern part, or is that that's the
northern? Well, actually, up there, I'm not sure if that is still township or that's been ever since closed.
Do you have a map of this area, or do we have?
Well, we can. Sure
do. I don't, so we can look and see what we're talking about.
Well, I can't remember that one road there goes up to a house.
Yeah, it pretty much dead ends in a house up north of Southern Star there. It goes by, it used to be a church
north or south.
Going south.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, it maybe would be really helpful to have a decent map. So maybe I see if Tony can.
One on the website.
What's that?
There one on the website.
Yeah, I think it's under cities service. Yeah.
Pat and I discussed that even if it is the county's responsibility, it's really.
This is Walmart over here. This is north. This is where the bones are. And this is the area. This road right here. And the road is quite a bit higher than the ground next to it. And of course, the road is south of here, I mean, would still remain a township road. This could be in the city. This down here is what is the city. So this is city back here.
I do not say that.
And this is city. So maybe that one does make sense to notify the city about the annexing the city that road. But it's not going to solve their problem, the city service problem, because I don't think the city or the municipality, I think, or the county, I think either has an obligation to make sure that the water gets on their property. And what we have there is adequate for our purposes. So it's just a natural drainage of the property. It's that natural drainage of the land goes into that property. So
our roadway isn't necessarily the cause of it.
No, it's a valet of the land. It's always.
It does stick kind of lower down in there when they build.
Yeah. So. And they talked, if the county or the city won't do anything, they'll have to fix themselves. They talked about putting a drain in there and just running it under their property out to the, I guess, road right away from the state.
And they also talked about putting a berm in.
Yeah.
I don't think we'll meet our regulations on the road. They have to go off the right away. I don't know if they do that, but it'd be hard.
Yeah, if it's off the right way, they do down.
The drain would probably make more sense.
And they can't push it back on us. That they have to deal with it. They can't just build a dike and make them up there.
There's a lot of piping in that area too, I imagine.
Oh,
yeah. Boy, couldn't move much dirt without moving a lot of pipe.
So the annexing thing, like on the west side of the road too, or is it strictly?
No, it's strictly on the east side.
East side of the road.
So if the city's maintaining that part north, it probably would be a big burden to put this on.
It's only a block long.
Yeah.
Yes. The city is maintaining Loveland Road and 274. We have up there is a block.
From the 73, that will run.
Yeah. Well, going north and south, all we have up there is a block. We go out to September Hills, not there anyway, but the city's there. It would make sense to me for the city to maintain it. We're only talking about a block long.
Township boards say they maintain the road.
Not this part of it. So this is a blacktop.
Oh, okay.
Where we're talking about farther north of there is rock.
Yeah.
And that would be township. But the part we're talking about is blacktop road. The county used to maintain it, and then the city annexed that Logan. I forget what the housing is down there, what they call that. But anyway, they annexed that, and when they annexed that, they took over the road.
I was wrong. Right across the road is Mar Hill, not Walmart. So it's a little.
So you just need to send notice to I don't know if there's anything. I mean, if the problem's been there, we're not causing a problem. They're going to need to try to fix it, we might guess, because I don't think our roads will still put in a drain.
Yeah, I really don't think it's the county or the city's problem to fix.
If it's in the city, they might have a little more problem with the fix, because they have to comply with the city's street regulations if they want to make a change.
Here's a question for you. I know, like with the culvert policy that we got in place, I mean, is it something that you prefer? I mean, that they would pay for labor and installation, or?
Well,
interviewed Matt a while back, and Pauline, I sent you a little...
That's downstairs.
Well, we probably ought to pick that up next week.
I'll bring the phone copy.
It's,
Or do we scan it and then turn it up?
Well, that's fine.
And may I go? I can go down and make copies and bring it up.
I've got, I don't know if you want to name it up, Black Air or...
Yeah, I think that's probably something you ought to read and approve. I tried to make it a little more clear that, we're not just in the business of creating culverts for anybody who wants one. That we're going to do it if it's our responsibility, not our responsibility. And then also giving them the option of doing the work themselves if they don't want to be able to count on it, but making sure that what they do is acceptable so they don't cut into our ditch or, cause standing water damage to the ditch.
The only other thing I had was actually, I've got the new, bridge reports. Really, most of it in there is maintenance issues. There's, I don't know if there's really anything to discuss. It's just, I'm going to get with my bridge foreman and just start working on, some maintenance issues. So... Other than that, there wasn't anything in there that was really unexpected.
Yeah, that's what it looked like on the script.
Yeah.
They did a pretty good job putting it together.
Yeah. Most of it's just, like I said, maintenance issues, small repairs. So.
If we heard any more on CADA for 2013 bridge inspections, have we heard any more from that?
I've not heard anything on that.
Has the other inspectors done any on our corrective code bridges?
Yeah, that's what this bridge inspection, I give you a copy of it there, I think last
week.
Yeah. That's what that was in that report. So that's all done. So.
I know KDOT hired another engineering company.
Well, okay. No, I haven't. We did the fracture critical inspections ourselves, but the state was going to come back and also do them, and I haven't heard when they're going to be doing that yet. I think they're going to try to get done this winter sometime, but I haven't heard.
Will that be for 2013?
The state's just going to do it on their own.
So those won't cost us?
No. Wow. The state's just doing it.
Checking the engineers and then inspecting them.
Right. Yeah. So. Basically, the state's going back and doing it to make sure they're in compliance with the feds. So. That's about all I had. I noticed in the paper the city was having another fall cleanup.
Saturday.
Are they going to be taking tires or anything?
No. Okay. No tires. Just not.
Yeah, there will be some probably household hazardous waste though on that.
Yeah, we've been in contact with Jackson County.
Okay.
We talked with them. They're going to have a trailer there.
Okay, that's good.
And they're just taking it directly out to recycling.
Right.
Much easier. So.
Yeah, we don't.
I don't suspect a whole lot. I think the spring is the big.
Yeah, I thought
the
fall was a smaller deal.
They said they have a trailer or something there. So
yeah.
It'll be replaced up in the stuff.
Right.
Heard any more from the trip?
I will get all the details. Exactly when we're leaving or where we're leaving from yet, but he You know, there was a few small spots, but nothing, it didn't come too bad. There were a few spots where it ran down the roads and put some little ditches in the roads, but nothing severe.
That's good.
Yeah.
Spots on the road where there's not much gravel.
Yeah, yeah. I had a haul of gravel yesterday and had the graders out today and probably hauling some more rock this week. So I guess I'll be up here again Monday morning at 9:30, and Tom Bennett is supposed to be up here. I think he's going to talk to you a little bit about that. Offset some bridge program. Yeah. And we will be able to, I believe on that one, we'll be able to use the exchange fund with the state, where we can exchange our federal money for state money, and that way we won't have to put quite as many bells and whistles on the bridge, like maybe not as much guardrail or things like that. So we won't have to, I don't think we'll have to comply with the federal standards, we'll just have to comply with the state standards.
Is there a big difference, or what do you see?
Tom Bennett can probably give us a little bit better idea and make sure, well, I'm right on this, but I'm pretty sure we can exchange the federal money for state money. And not necessarily build a cheaper rig, but one that doesn't have to comply with some of the federal standards.
Well, it's probably closer. I would assume KDOT standards are probably more accurate or close to what we deal with.
Right, right. Yep. All right.
Thank you.
Yep. Have a good day.
We'll try.
Yeah.
You had gotten a letter from Dorothy Schletzbaum at Mount Vernon Cemetery,
mm-hmm.
and asked me to do a little looking into it. I did some research. I also talked with Galen Pruitt, whom I talk to every time the cemetery issue comes up. And he is also on board at Mount Vernon. Mount Vernon is a cemetery association. That means they're a private corporation. They receive no tax subsidy, no public funding of any sort. Ms. Schletzbaum in her letter made reference to the possibility of the county doing some assistance to them, and made reference to the city taking over Oak Hill Cemetery. Oak Hill Cemetery, as I remember, was taken over by the city under pretty much different circumstances. I think the owners kind of just ran off with I made some sales and ran off with some money, and I had not looked, but I bet that there's a statute that requires the city to take over if there's a cemetery within the city. There is a statute that requires a...
I don't think this is that circumstance.
Well, this one certainly isn't abandoned. An abandoned requires under the statute 5 years without mowing or anything. And that doesn't fall back on the county. It falls back on the township under the statute. Curiously, it allows for the township to spend not more than $500 a year for mowing on the cemetery, which I think, and he told me that they spend $2,500 or something like that every time they mow the cemetery, because it's 42 acres and you have to mow around all the monuments. You can't just mow.
Sure.
You can't just mow over it all. There is a statute that allows the Board of Commissioners to create a cemetery district. Could create a cemetery district, which would be a tax and subdivision. They have to go out to voter approval in the it's to that point if they want to do something like that, although you may be having a discussion with them. You're not under any obligation to do anything. You're not under any obligation. You're not under any risk of being forced to take them over it. And I don't think they're anywhere near failing. I think they have a $400,000 endowment. Just the income off the endowment isn't sufficient to cover their expenses, or it is really close. So we'll talk again with Galen to let him know that. But if you wanted to put some appropriation in a budget, like you do for Happy Hearts Learning Center or Amelia Heart Festival or something, you could do that. Just a lot of non-objection to.
And then, real quick before we get to the elevator project, right away on Water District Number 5, there was a request some time ago.
I went out and met with, I can't remember his name, their employee, got the general areas where they wanted, and working on getting their easements ready for them. Bill Elias talked to him. He needs to approve the easements before you do, because it isn't just simply a grant. That will require them to do some things too for compliance. And I sent a second email to Gene Kelly yesterday. I think I copied you on it.
Yeah.
I did not get a response to that. Yeah. She had copied, it looked like, several of her coworkers. I don't know if those were supervisors or supervisees that she had copied on her email, but I copied them on mine as well.
Oh, good.
So I will, if I don't get a response from her today, I'll call. I'll let you know.
Yeah, hopefully we can get that report by end of this week. If we really need to get that, needs to be going.
Yeah, yeah. And especially if it's something she said she already sent us.
What did you do with the other one? Oh, okay. So what was the original price that you really was it, is it the same about the same price as the first one that you looked at? Mm-hmm. Okay. Sure, we get a purchase order. just get us a purchase order request on it.
Thanks, Gail.
Thanks. Gail's supposed to have a purchase order request, approximately $250 for a Schickel barn door. I guess the one that we gave them approval to was not good, so they didn't get it.
She said this one includes a brand new, extra brand new bar in place.
So we got a brand new elevator on sale for us?
I'm
always laughing at that. Wait for Sarah, is she coming up or do you know?
She should be here.
Okay. No big surprises lately with it?
There we are. Not too far. Except that.
Really?
Everything go okay with the power switch over?
So far, I think it was.
I've
had some catches at WeWorks.
Yeah, Monday.
All afternoon. As of yesterday morning, everything's fine.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Is that speaker of the angel?
I'd rather be more than that. I'll take that. Yesterday. So other than that, we're kind of working on odds and ends.
window where we've got the conduits going through.
Right.
Just had that fiberboard in there.
Mm-hmm. So you're really, what, 98%, 99% finished?
I might say at least 95, if not.
Yeah. Pretty close.
It'll take just a little bit to get all the labels in the right place. We may have to. There were a couple that weren't quite matching up with what was on the old panels, and or not so much not matching up, but they would have tandem or more than one wire on a breaker. And so we may have to figure out where all those went, but it shouldn't be that bad. So,
so other than that, that's really bad.
Yeah, I guess the one thing that did pop up with the electrical was that one, the tree face. Kind of what, Thursday last week, I think?
Yeah.
We found out that, I guess the condenser units that are outside, they're outside that little balcony area on the second floor. There are actually three phase rather than two phase. They had to get an additional breaker to bump those up, and it was $300-some.
$370 or $380.
We just went ahead and had him go ahead and do that because he's got him the condenser unit to be worse.
That might have been a little warm yesterday.
Yeah. So schedule-wise, then we are still plenty within schedule. I think
we're still on schedule as far as our time limit. Of course, really, I thought that we're ahead of schedule. But as far as contract, it was ahead of schedule.
Yeah, I think they are looking at those change orders. I think from the restroom, we have that technically where it's supposed to be by September 10th, which I guess it's Monday, but it's according to the number of days that we have for the contract, I think on the restroom we're supposed to be done on September 10th, which is next Monday. I think you're going to be...
Yeah, we're not going to be able to work in there because of elevator people, so only thing we have, well, one thing left to do in there after today or tomorrow morning would probably be floor tile and finish the plumbing up. We have ceilings put in, but we're not going to be able to work in there because of the bathroom, or excuse me, because of the elevator. But also, even if we were finished with it, we still have to keep the clothes off because of the elevator people and one thing or another. So, really, as you look at it, we really can't use the restroom until we're finished with the elevator because we're going to have people working going in and out of the room. Put the floors down, so even if we get it finished, it probably still can't use it.
As long as everybody's okay that it maybe is slightly past that date, and not cause problems.
That's understandable. Okay. Projects like that, and it's loaded up.
Well, we did run into a few glitches on that part.
Yeah, we probably lost a month, I would say, anyway. You don't want to kind of extend all of that, but you want to do this.
Between all the piping.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Well, so we'll wait on the elevator. That's really where we need to be then, get the elevator in and...
Like I said, it's not really an elevator company, it's a drilling company.
Sure.
That comes in and drills, and we're the ones running behind.
Any questions or anything, concerns on the county?
So overall, time frame, you think that
we should be, we'll be finished ahead of schedule, I think, or?
Schedule was originally, the number of days that we had was supposed to be January 8th.
Okay.
Which should be well before the time.
We should be, we'll be done and hopefully as soon as possible, but then
before
November. What's that?
Before Christmas.
Yeah, before Christmas.
So we can put the bells and whistles on it.
There you go.
Wonder, do you know how long the elevator, how long it'll take for them to get there? How long is it going to take them?
It usually takes about a week for installation.
Yeah, they're going to have to drill.
Yeah.
So really, probably, if they could get in after drill, you know, they could be done in a week. I'd say probably
question for you. We still have people coming in and out of the door on the east side. We really need to work on, I mean, especially we got an elevator, we got safety, we got people coming in and out. We need to really somehow get non-people that are working on the elevator to stop using that. And we have several courthouse employees that are using it. So we need to come up with a solution to just shut that down except for...
You know, we could probably just put some cones all the way across it.
Yeah, whatever you do, somebody's going to go across it. Say that we might...
I'm just worried about liability issue, you know.
We might get some caution tape and they go on the other side of that. I think it's kind of on to them at that point. We probably have to put some outside and inside.
Maybe we could.
So we can't lock the door because the fire...
No, I know that, but I mean...
If it wasn't for that, we could just lock it and all the people who were working through that key, but can't do that.
So why don't we try putting some cones all the way across the bottom of the stairs right there? And we can
a lot of us people going out, they don't...
Do we have anything, can we put something inside to keep...
We could also put some cones or some caution tape kind of from the corner of Lampy's office over to the stairway. We could do that, corner the stairway.
I think that would help.
Yeah.
Maybe get a cone or something to kind of pull it out a little bit.
Sounds like paper signs on doors are stopping people from using.
No.
I'm just worried about someone getting hurt, you know.
Yeah. And then we've got to use the stairs quite a bit, you know, more than the house.
Yeah, exactly.
You try that.
Okay. We can try that and see what happens.
Yeah. And we could probably maybe also put caution tape on and then just go under the caution tape on the inside.
Good.
Okay. Let me, can you review change orders or under a document? Want to add in the number of days for on the restroom to extend it out.
say probably at least minimum 30 days, if not more.
Do you want to just put 30 days on there? We can adjust it that way.
Is it going to be 60 before the other project is done anyway?
Will it be finished?
Yeah.
It'll be finished, but probably still can't use it.
Yeah. I mean, I would suggest maybe putting 60 on it.
Okay. Okay, you can have 60 days on there.
Mm-hmm.
The
elevator to the restroom.
To the restroom.
Yeah, even if it was finished right now, I'd say we still can't. Wouldn't be able to tell if you would.
Yeah, it'd be pretty dangerous.
Yeah, especially with the elevator work going on, because open doors. Yeah, we've got some barricades built for the elevator company. They're going to be getting in and out. We decided that we built some temporary flooring for that we've been platforms working off of, and the elevator company decided that they like the idea, so we're going to go ahead and leave them in there, and they're going to do their work off of them. Then we've got to go in and pull them out. But once we do that, which will probably be sometime next week, they're still going to be open all the way up and down with some barricades in front of it. So,
okay. So if we had a 50 day bed fence at November 9th, is that all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Mr. Chairman, I move that I have the chairman sign this AIA document G701. 2001 for contract changes.
Second that. All favor, signify, say aye.
Aye.
You'll have another one here just one second.
So you need all four of you?
Yeah, we'll do all four, and then that way everybody will have a copy. And then the bathroom only has three, because Kathy doesn't need one. Restroom.
And then do we get to go on a field trip today?
Absolutely. Wouldn't be a complete visit without a swimming.
Prep for my sack lunch.
Mr. Chairman, I also move to re-sign the
yes.
Okay.
That's all in there. electric wall, one for the restroom.
Okay, three panes. Keep track of who gets what there. You can go a little better.
Absolutely.
Oh, actually, before we go off around, why don't we go ahead and set our next meeting?
Okay.
And you said that...
They're supposed to, they're supposed to be on the 17th, so, you know, I should make it.
Yeah.
Sometime after that, but hopefully see the elevator.
Pretty good.
Getting installed.
So if we did, well, if they start on the 17th, we could say a full 4 weeks from today, and that puts us at October 3rd.
Okay.
Surely the dog can be done by then.
I would hope so.
Will that work?
Yeah.
How about, free work your schedule a little bit, okay? So let's start on October 3rd. What time? 10 o'clock.
I
24. So here in the next couple of weeks, you should be receiving those bids.
Monday, November 12th.
days that